Play Show, written by Ray Singer and Dick Chevrolet, with Elliot Lewis, Walter Tetley, Robert North, Janine Ruth, and Whitfield, Walter Sharp and his music, yours truly, Bill Foreman, and starring Alice Faye and Bill Harris.
I rushed over here as fast as I could to tell you the news.
What news?
Oh, you'll never believe it. Never. Oh, wait till I tell you. Just wait.
We're waiting. We're waiting. Tell us what happened.
Last night, I flushed my trough.
It serves you right. You know you shouldn't have left anything heavy. Got a weak back and them cough muscles are easily plied.
Philip, you don't understand. Last night, I plighted my troth, and tomorrow, I'm entering connubial bliss.
Well, why don't you go to a good hospital like Cedars 11?
I give up. Now, sister, what do you think of the news?
Well, I think it's wonderful.
What's wonderful?
He's going to get married.
In his condition? It's a physical wreck. Willie, what kind of a girl would marry you?
She's a very lovely girl. Oh, just wait till you see Chloe.
Well, I'll be very happy to... Chloe? That explains why she wants to marry you. She's been in that swamp so long, she's forgotten what a man's supposed to be.
Willie, what does your fiancée look like?
Oh, Alice, she is a lovely thing. And I'm very lucky to get her, of course. She too is lucky to have caught me.
Yeah, she'd have been luckier if she'd have stayed in that swamp with a reed in her mouth. Hey, Willie, how long have you known this alligator wrestler?
Did you meet this girl, Willie?
Well, I only met her a week ago. We were introduced at a party and she fell for me. I remember the hostess said, Chloe, I want you to meet William Bay.
And she fell for you right away?
No, not that fast. It was my personality that got her. It's amazing. All I said was one little word and she fell madly in love with me.
Yeah? What'd you say?
Well, after we were introduced, she said, are you William Fay, the brother of the wealthy Alice Fay? I said, yes, and the next thing I knew, she was in my arms. Oh, the passion I must have in my voice.
For all the money your sister has in the bank.
Willie, I hate to say this, but I think this girl is a fortune hunter.
How can you say a thing like that? Chloe is not interested in money. She said she loves me because of my brain. She thinks I have a good head on my shoulders.
Oh, I see. She ain't a fortune hunter. She's a head hunter. You do have a very unusual shaped noggin. Yes, sir. That ought to shrink down pretty good. Unscrew it. Let me have a look at it. My, this is a collector's item. I haven't seen a head like this since 3.2 beers.
Bill, give him back his head.
You two will find out how wrong you are about Chloe when you meet her. She's coming over here at 4 o'clock, and I thought we'd all have tea together.
Oh, goody. We're all going to orange pico it up, huh?
Now, why didn't you tell me?
Oh, I was so excited just sitting around my... Oh, that must be Chloe now. Oh, Alice, will you please let her in? I want to straighten my hair and comb my tie.
Very well, I'll let her in.
Hey, Alice. Hey, wait a minute, honey. I got to go with you. I can't wait to get a look at this day. I wonder what she's like.
You know, from what Willie said, she must be a gold digger. She just wants to marry into the family to get her hands on the Fay money.
It ain't going to do her no good. I know. I've been digging around for years. Go ahead.
We'd better let her in. Hi, How do you do?
I'm Chloe Johnson, and you must be William's sister, Alice Faye.
Hi.
My, what a beautiful home you have here. It must have cost you at least $75,000. And I'll bet you have it free and clear. And just look at that Persian rug. Why, that must have cost you at least $2,000. And that piano, you couldn't possibly get it for less than $1,500.
If you're through with the appraisal, we'd like to say hello.
I'm sorry, Chloe. Oh, Miss Bay, that necklace you're wearing. Real pearls, aren't they? I'll bet that cost you at least $1,000.
Well, I really don't remember. Wouldn't you like to step in?
Yes, come on in. Let me have your $8 coat and I'll hang it on our $49.95 coat fridge. I like to introduce myself. I am...
Oh, I know who you are. You're William's father.
Crack like that, and I'm going to kick her right in the head with my $65 alligator shoe.
Say, your father is certainly a well-preserved old man. My, he's so neat and dapper.
Yes, we try to keep him clean. Of course, at his age, it's rather hot.
Yes, it's me, William. Oh, pardon me, folks. I must rush in and kiss my lover boy.
Well, be careful. Don't get any lipstick on his 2250 suit with them two pair knickers.
Phil, that girl's a fortune hunter, and we've got to find some way to discourage her from marrying Willie. If there were only some way we could scare her and... Phil, you sing.
What kind of a crack was that?
That way. I have the start of an idea, and I can think much better when you sing.
Well, I still don't like it, but I'm going to do it. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Don't let the moon break your heart. Love blooms at night, and daylight it dies. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Don't keep your heart from beating, for someday I'll return. Though you're the only one I'll ever love. Too many nights, too many stars, too many moons to change your mind. If I'm gone too long, don't forget where you belong. When the stars come up, remember you were mine. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Don't let the moon break your heart. Love blooms at night, and daylight it dies. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Keep your heart for me, for someday I'll return.
Okay.
Remember, keep your mind on your work. Don't be swayed by her pretty face.
Oh, brilliant. You're so masterful. I just love to sit here on your lap with my arms around
you. Please, you're wilting my celluloid collar.
Oh, that ain't no son of mine. Let's get out of here.
Willie, I'd like to have a girl-to-girl talk with Chloe. So, would you mind leaving us alone for a while?
You better get lost, Willie. Look, take a ride around the park. Here's your bicycle clip.
Thank you. Well, I'll see you soon, Chloe. I hope you girls have a nice chat. Bye.
Bye. There goes my youngest boy, Will. Off the cycle around the park on his little three wheel.
You should be proud of your son, William.
Yes, little lady. I should, but I ain't. That boy's been nothing but trouble to me since the day he was hatched.
Well, I remember you said you wanted to talk to Chloe about other things.
Oh, yes. Boy, child, I want to talk to you. So why don't you just sacay over here and sit on your old daddy-in-law's lap? Now, that's a good girl. You just cozy right in there. Just sit right
there. Father?
Down. Get up. I'm going to have to part my little daughter here. She's a point killer.
What would you like to talk to me about? Daddy?
Well, I'd like to talk to you about
William.
There goes my point killing daughter. Join your brother in the ride around the park. There's a clip for you, too. Now, pedal backwards. Don't hurry back.
Cut that out. I'm not going anyplace. Father, Chloe wants to marry William, and I think you ought to tell her about it.
Oh, yes, of course, about William. Well, now I realize that he isn't much to look at on the surface, little girl. But I want you to know that underneath, he's a seething mass of nothing.
About your own son.
It ain't hard. Now, shall we discuss the financial arrangement? You see, Chloe, any girl who marries William will receive a financial settlement from me.
Oh, you mean if I marry William, I'll get a dowry?
Well, it ain't exactly a dowry. We call it a reward. But you will receive the sum of
$8.
$1.95 in cash and a slow note for the balance.
I never heard of an $8 dowry.
I know, but you see, Willie doesn't have any money of his own.
Did you say William doesn't have any money?
Nary a sight.
But I heard that the Fay family's very wealthy and... Oh, I see. All this belongs to you, Miss Fay. You have all the money.
No. This doesn't belong to me. I'm broke. I lost all my money.
Well, but the sumptuous house and these expensive furnishings must belong to... Oh, I see. It all belongs to you, Mr. Fay.
Well, I don't want to...
I might have known. Under that handsome curly hair is a shrewd money-making brain.
But aren't you reaching for the moon? course, if it means you're happy, Miss Knight, dear, I'm willing to...
Break it up.
Chloe, excuse us for a minute. Father, come into the other room. I want to talk to you alone. What are you trying to do, you old roué?
Well, I was only doing it for you.
For me?
Certainly, I'm trying to make her forget Willie. I thought I'd marry her for a week or two.
Oh, there must be some other way of getting rid of this girl.
All right, how?
We'll have to find some man who has a lot of money and throw him at her. Now, who do we know who has a lot of money and... I've got it. Elliot.
He got a fist.
I know that, but Chloe doesn't. And all we have to do is tell her that Elliot is a wealthy playboy and she'll drop Willie like a hot potato. You call Elliot, explain what you want him to do and tell him to come right in.
Now, look, Elliot. Now, you've been paying attention. You know exactly what we want you to do.
Oh, yeah.
You're going to pick a better man. Being a playboy is right up my alley. Yeah, I know that's where you usually play, but tonight I want you out of there. Now, look, are you sure you can play the part naturally? You notice I'm dressed for the role.
Yeah, I noticed the clothes.
Those are clothes, aren't they?
Please.
This is my playboy outfit. Purple beret, pale fudge scarf, tangerine bolero, and checkered plus four. You think I need something else to set this off?
Oh, leave it alone. It'll explode by...
Where's this girl I'm supposed to romance?
Look, she's inside with Alice. Now, come on, let's go in. Elliot.
What?
Now, remember, I want you to lay it on heavy. You're supposed to be one of the richest men in the world. Now, in order to impress this dame, all you have to do is to keep talking about money. Money. Talk about nothing. Just money. Money. Money.
Got it.
Okay. Oh, Alice, dear.
What is it, Father?
Look who just dropped in. This is our wealthy friend, Elliot Van Finkelfinger III.
But of course. How are you, Finky? Darson, I'd like you to meet our millionaire friend, Elliot Van Finkelfinger III.
Well, I've never met a millionaire before. How are you, Mr. Van Finkelfinger?
Oh, I'm money, thank you. And how money are you, my dear? Hey, Fink, come here.
What? I wouldn't go that heavy. I think you're going
too much.
I'd say with just a wee bit, yeah, it ain't that much money.
Leave him alone. I like what he has to say. If you're a millionaire, you must have money.
That's a shrewd observation.
How much would you say you have, Mr. Van Finkelfinger?
Oh, I have scats, gobs, and oodles. Of course, I have a few more scats than I have oodles, but my gobs keep piling up.
I'd just love to talk to you successful men. Tell me, did you make your money yourself?
Heavens, no. I had it made by Hattie Carnegie. Nothing like custom-made money, I always say. Would you care to see my new off-the-shoulder $20 bill? Or I have a five with a plunging neckline that's real sexy.
You're so cute. It would be stimulating to be married to a man like you, but unfortunately, I can't marry you.
Why not, my darling?
Because I promised my hand to another man.
Well, give him your hand. I'll take what's left. I've always been one for potluck.
Chloe, why don't you forget William and Dad and marry Elliot?
Anthony, hold the front of grocery.
Do you think I should, Miss Fay?
Certainly. A girl like you deserves Elliot.
Well, I certainly like a man like him. In fact, I'd like nothing better than to marry a man as handsome, as intelligent, and as wealthy as you, Elliot.
What was that last half-witted remark, lady?
I said I'd like to marry Elliot.
What did you say, my dear?
She said you're a smooth, sophisticated swab.
Hey, groceries, over here, please. Excuse us a minute, Chloe.
Mr. Alice, what's going on here?
Look, I'll explain. This girl wants to marry Willie because of Alice's money, so I'm pretending that I'm Alice's father to talk her into marrying Elliot, the wealthy playboy.
Huh?
We'll go once more.
wants to marry Willie because of Alice's money. So I'm pretending that I'm Alice's father to talk her into marrying Elliot, the wealthy playboy, and we got to do it before Willie gets back on his bicycle.
How's the bicycle get in the act?
Ah, Chloe, you and I will be so happy together. With all my money, we'll have a wonderful life. Just think, we'll spend the winter at my chalet in Saint Moritz. In the spring, we'll go to my chateau in Paris. And in the fall, we'll spend on my yacht in the Mediterranean.
And where will we spend the summer?
On his live bait barge off Chisholm Beach.
Just run along, and when Willie comes back, I'll break the bad news to him. I know he'll be heartbroken, but...
Well, I'm back, everybody.
Willie, get off the bicycle. You're in the house.
Oh, I'm so excited I forgot to get off. Oh, while I was gone, I kept thinking of you, Chloe. Did you miss me, dear? What did you do while I was gone?
Oh, she's been a busy little bee, that one. First she jilted you, then me, and now she's working on Stinky. That's Stinky.
Don't believe it. Chloe wouldn't look at any other man but me.
Are you kidding? I just remembered seeing this girl downtown yesterday. Some guy pulled up in a big Cadillac, humped his horn, she got in, and he took her for a ride.
That's not true. I don't allow strange men to pick me up.
You don't? Huh?
No, I don't. Now, Elliot, let's...
I'm coming. On my way, babe.
Oh, thank you, sir. I'd be glad to take a ride.
But all I did was...
Everybody.
Ever wonder what's going on in an Air Force race relations seminar? Well, listen. Some of the exercises that are used in a seminar are geared at teaching one group about the other group. On many occasions, the exercises